Thank you, Hibak, and thank you, Karama. And I'm so glad to see you all. In fact, at this very specific occasion, I personally did not know Salwa, but I feel like I know her very well, because she is, in my opinion, the symbol for all women in our region who are fighting for justice, equality, gender equality, fighting for democracy, fighting for ending wars, conflicts, occupation in our situation as Palestinians, and in building a society where we can live decently as Palestinians and as the people all over the world. So actually, I'm so happy and honored to be speaking today on the memorial of the sixth memorial of Salwa, and especially at this very difficult period in the in all around the world, and the threats that are facing humanity generally, whether because of COVID-19 or because of the political conflicts, social crisis all around the world, and the social problems and inequality that is prevailing. We as Palestinian women, I do remember when I was only 6 years and a half or 7 years old, when the occupation started in Palestine. And we never thought, and I never thought that my son would become such an 32 years old man who is still living under occupation. And that, if the impact on us as Palestinian women is still more, there's a multi-layer of oppression being in patriarchal structures as well, being under occupation. So definitely now we look at, you know, our right to live in peace and in security, human security more than anything else, as very important, because we see all the international community that are not taking the responsibilities under international human rights law and humanitarian law to end the situation under which we have been living and suffering as Palestinians and as Palestinian women. When we look at the situation, we even noticed, even during the lockdown and COVID-19, that the Palestinian women have been suffering more than any others because of the occupation and because of the Israeli systematic policies that continued unabated during the closure and during the current situation. So in my opinion, as long as there is no just and durable solution to all the conflicts and all the wars in our region, including the ending of the Israeli military occupation, belligerent occupation, we're not going to live in peace. I think that we should continue our fight and continue to make the international community responsible for taking up their legal and moral obligations. Perhaps we're speaking to closed ears or nobody is listening to us, but we have to continue to make our messages and to make the women, peace and security agenda more heard at the international level, even if nobody is taking us seriously. This year, more than ever, because we are on the 20th anniversary of the women, peace and security, we have to think together as Karama group in our region. How could we do the right messaging? We want justice. We want accountability to human rights defenders. We want to see security to our peoples, to our children, to our own communities. We have to demand our right for peace, because the peace that we talk about is genuine. We women representing the peoples, but also specifically because we live under oppression within our own societies, very much understand what it really means to live in security, because we know that we are being used during conflicts as a tool of war. We know that we are going to suffer more under natural disasters or under political disasters and conflicts. And we have seen that during COVID-19. If you see how much we have suffered as Palestinian women, and I'm sure this reflects because I've been in networks in our region and all worldwide, because of our traditional roles as caregivers and responsible for the household and the children and the sick and the disabled and everything, we have been overburdened by additional responsibilities within the household. And we had to endure the health situation combined, in our situation as Palestinians, combined with the Israeli systematic violations that continued under the shadow of COVID-19. And we have seen a huge campaign internally against Palestinian women because the cabinet tried, with the increase of the cases of violence against women, to pass the family protection law. So I look at this as very much interconnected. And I look at our sufferings and our calls for more justice and peace as being very much interconnected. I really think that the key issue is not to continue speaking only about political participation. This is very important. We have to be in political decision making, but also in protection, but we have to be active active players. We have to really demand our right to participate in decision making and in building peace and security to our own people and to our own families and to our own societies and communities. We have to demand really to have, we have to try to translate the Women, Peace and Security Agenda and the National Action Plans into more accountable documents that make our states and governments more accountable before the international community. We don't want it to be voluntarily. We don't want them to be with a good reputation that they are respecting the Women, Peace and Security Agenda. We want them to implement it, to allocate funds and to make it feasible, because they speak very nicely with the rhetoric, but there's nothing on the ground. And we really want to see a better world. And I think with just covering up and giving cosmetic service or lip service to the rights of women without really engaging them and engaging us in meaningful participation as well, is going to keep us revolving around this whole situation. We have to continue to demand for the stop of the flood of weaponry in our region, arming the people and making them fight us, encouraging fundamentalism to grow in our region for political reasons, and we are paying the price as women and girls in our own societies. So we have a lot to put forward. My only message is that let's think together and build on this webinar for future dialogue and discussions among us. Use this occasion of Salwa and her memorial today in order to think, how could we serve justice for all of us and for Salwa in really building mechanisms to justice and peace and equality in our region. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.